Hello everybody, my name is Antonio Loquercio and I'm a PhD student in robotics at the University of Zurich. In this talk, I'm gonna present my work, A General Framework for Uncertainty Estimation in Deep Learning. Nowadays, deep learning has been more and more integrated into robotic systems. However, a robot cannot blindly trust the prediction of a neural network. In fact, what happens if the current observation is very different from the training ones? Or what if some of the sensors fail? A wrong prediction because of this can be very problematic for a robot, and also for the surrounding of it. Think, for example, about an autonomous car. To detect and avoid this wrong prediction, we propose a general framework for uncertainty estimation of deep neural networks. In deep neural networks, our framework can model the uncertainty in neural networks coming from two sources: data uncertainty and model uncertainty. The data uncertainty usually describes the uncertainty coming from the sensor noise, while the model uncertainty describes how much a neural network is uncertain about its own prediction. With respect to state-of-the-art, we propose two major innovations. First, we propose to use prior information about the data that a robot has in the form of sensor noise to predict better uncertainty. And also, we propose to model the relationship between the two uncertainties, the data and the model, to better predict the total uncertainty of a neural network. In addition, our framework has some interesting features. In particular, it's agnostic to the neural architecture and task. It's also agnostic to the learning process. That means it can be applied to any training procedure, and also with any training procedure, and also it can be applied to already trained neural networks. To model the data uncertainty, we use assumed density filtering. Specifically, we fit every neural network node with a Gaussian distribution and set the input Gaussian distributions with the noise coming from the sensor cheat sheet. In addition, compute model uncertainty using Monte Carlo dropout, which basically boils down to create Bayesian belief networks, putting a probability distribution on every of the network weights. The usual approach for finding the total uncertainty is just to sum the two. So data uncertainty, model uncertainty, just sum them. However, this approach, which is usually done, discards any dependencies between the data and model uncertainty. But this is fundamentally wrong, because high sensor noise can also result in high model uncertainty. For this reason, we propose to compute the total uncertainty as an average of Bayesian networks, Bayesian belief networks, which can give a better estimate of the total uncertainty with respect to the classical summing approach. All the details of this are provided in the paper. We demonstrate our framework on four tasks: end-to-end steering angle prediction, object future motion prediction, object recognition, and closed-loop control of a quadruped. On steering angle prediction, we adapt a neural network used to predict steering angle from images, and add also uncertainty estimation that you can now see in several colors, red and yellow. Red for the first standard deviation and yellow for the others. Our framework has not only very high prediction in steering angle, but also very accurate uncertainty estimation, which none of the state-of-the-art methods have at the same time. In object future motion prediction, instead, we predict how an object will move in the future, but of course, this also has uncertainty. And again, we perform this task with higher accuracy and with better uncertainty estimation than state-of-the-art approaches. We also evaluate on an object recognition task on the popular CIFAR-10 dataset, where we again obtain, with respect to previous tasks, with respect to previous work, a high accuracy in estimation and a very good uncertainty fitting. We also studied the problem of closed-loop control of a quadrotor, where we basically showed that keeping uncertainty into consideration for control, specifically do not apply an action if the neural network is not really sure about that, improves tracking performance and decreases the odds of a crash. So the main takeaways of our work is that it's important to use any prior information we have about our data and uncertainty estimation, and that's very important for a robotic system. And also, it's also fundamental to keep into account the relationship between the two sources of uncertainty, data and model. Thank you for your attention.